Hey guys, welcome to episode 7 of the Strength Series. These episodes are about gaining muscle and cutting fat, specifically for guys. In this episode, I'm going to talk about how to increase your insulin sensitivity. In the last episode, I talked about insulin resistance. If you're insulin resistant, you're more likely to store any carbohydrates you eat as fat. When you eat carbohydrate or a large portion of protein, that gets broken down and glucose is released into the bloodstream. Your body needs to deal with that, so your pancreas is going to release insulin. You have receptors in your muscle and fat cells, and they're going to activate in the presence of insulin, and they're going to draw the glucose out of the bloodstream. When you're having sugary foods or you're snacking throughout the day, you're triggering lots of these blood sugar spikes, and that's going to release insulin every single time. Eventually, your receptors become less responsive to insulin. So your pancreas needs to release more to deal with the same amount of glucose. If you're insulin resistant, you release 5 to 7 times as much insulin as a regular person would. Why is that a problem? Well, that's a problem because in the presence of any insulin, all fat-burning hormones are shut down. When you eat carbohydrate, your body is switching off fat-burning mode in order to deal with the food that you just ate. Your goal is to be more sensitive to insulin because we're talking about those receptors in your body. You want them to jump into action at the smallest release of insulin. So that is true whether you're trying to gain muscle or lose fat. That's because as well as keeping you burning fat by controlling your insulin, you can also help build muscle more effectively. So with that in mind, here are 15 ways to increase your insulin sensitivity starting today. Number one, stop eating 6 times a day. It's fine if you're having a moderate dose of protein and maybe some healthy fats, but if you're having a banana mid-morning, then insulin is being released. 2, avoid sugary drinks. Around half of the sugar in things like Coke and Pepsi, as well as sports drinks, is fructose. That is a fruit sugar and can only be dealt with by the liver. In too high a dose, it will interfere with insulin signaling and cause fat storage. 3, limit your fruits. As I said, we want to manage fructose. In order to improve your insulin sensitivity, it's a good idea to cut down on high fructose fruits like bananas and apples, as well as most dried fruits. A limit of 1 to 2 pieces a day is said to be effective. 4, avoid sweeteners. Just because they're 0 calories doesn't mean they can't trigger insulin. This study showed a 20% increase in insulin when someone consumed a drink with artificial sweeteners in it compared to water when taken with the meal. So it's best to stick with water and avoid diet drinks, particularly at meal times. 5, reduce your body fat. This is particularly true if you're obese, as you're likely already storing the carbs that you eat as body fat. If you follow a lower carb diet, you should be able to bring your body fat percentage down to a healthy range. If you are 25% body fat or above, you can follow a diet of 50 grams or less of carbohydrate a day in order to lose weight. If you're carrying a bit of extra weight, you could limit your carbs to 150 or 200 grams and also make sure to put them either at breakfast time or around your workout. 6, exercise. Muscle consumes the majority of the glucose in your blood, so doing intense exercise like weightlifting or high intensity interval training is a very effective way of improving sensitivity. Charles Poliquin said that if you increase muscle mass by 10%, you can expect to improve the way that you handle your carbohydrates by around 11%. 7, get enough sleep. Studies have shown that a single night of poor sleep can contribute to insulin resistance. 8, increase your fibre intake. This will slow down digestion and the release of sugar into the bloodstream from the gut. The best sources of fibre are vegetables. 9, avoid trans fats. Trans fats are used to extend shelf life and can be found in certain biscuits, cakes and pastries. They move your insulin sensitivity in the wrong direction and will promote belly fat. 10, improve your omega-6 to 3 ratio. I covered omega-6 in my health series, I put the link in the description below. In a typical Western diet, our ratio is 16 to 1, whereas ideally we would want 4 to 1 or less. Omega-6 is found in a lot of cooking oils, nuts, and nearly all processed foods. Omega-3 could be taken as a supplement, or better still, make sure you get several portions of wild salmon a week, as well as a portion of the other oily fish like mackerel and sardines. 11, get more magnesium. Studies have shown that increasing magnesium will improve sensitivity. You'll get it in leafy greens like spinach, as well as foods like pumpkin and sesame seeds. You can also take a supplement. I take ZMA before bed, which is zinc and magnesium. 12, drink some green tea. Green tea has been shown to improve the uptake of glucose into muscle and reduce the uptake into body fat. 13, there are things you can add to your food to balance blood sugar. Cinnamon is great for lowering the spike in your blood sugar levels. Remember, that is something like ground cinnamon, not cinnamon grahams. Other foods that help include sauerkraut, apple cider vinegar, turmeric, and walnuts. Eat these with your high carb meals for a more sustained release of energy. 14, when dealing with protein, try to avoid combining it with sugar. Instead, try to combine it with some healthy fats, as the addition of fat will buffer the release of insulin. Finally, 15, be aware that a large portion of protein can also trigger an insulin release. I think a good max is around 50 grams of protein in a single meal. The better you stick to these guidelines, the sooner you can restore your insulin sensitivity. If you think you might be insulin resistant, you can check out a great video by Dr. Berg, which I've put in the description below. To steal from his checklist, symptoms of chronically elevated insulin levels include belly fat, swollen ankles, a strong craving for carbs, a feeling like you need to nap after each meal, and brain fog. That's it for today. In the next episode, I'm going to cover good food sources for gaining muscle or losing fat. Thanks for watching.